Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om
شغل التمرينات السمستي وإنما ما هو شغل آية كشنا برش آية وكلي شهيري بطي بدن تسامي تنامي نمستي ساسا دیوی گوروانی بچاروی دیوی سے شاسون نمانی پاس آتے دے ستارمی پانچا کل پدر ویسا پرواس نبیا بچا پتیتا نام پاونے بیو وشنو بیو نمون نما جائے شری کرشن چیتنیا پربو نتیانا شری ادوائیتا گناتا سباسا دی گورمت مند ہرے کرشن ہرے کرشن 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 ہرے 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 رام ہرے رام I'm very, very happy for some of you all here. Very sincere students here. I'm in Faryatra. And today we'll discuss about all of the aspects, all of the problem. Second is Devata of Pratishtha, third is Swayambhu. The three types of deities is there. Brahmana Pratishtha means pure Brahmanas, they do, that is called Pratishtha Vidhi. Pratishtha Vidhi. In Vedas, they have a system of invoking the Lord from the Vaikuntha or Goloka to this planet. They invite, that is called Pratishtha Vidhi. Very beautiful process is there. Pure Brahmanas, they invite, pure devotees, they invite the Lord. Lord will come and stay. They construct the temple and Lord will come and stay. This one, Acharya says, this deity effect will be 10,000 yojanas. Brahmana, Pratishtha deity, his influence will be 10,000 yojana. One yojana is 8 miles. One yojana is, these are very temples. And second is Devata Pratishtha. Sometimes Devatas come and do Pratishtha. Indra, Chandra, Brahma, all they do Vishnu, Vishnu Deity Pratishtha. The deity will be effect on total planet, that effect will be there. And third is Swayambhu. Swayambhu means Lord comes, nobody will make deity, nobody will do Pratishtha. Lord comes and manifests as a deity. Directly from Vaikuntha comes and stands there for devotees. This is called Swayambhu. This Balaji is Swayambhu. His effect will be full Brahmanda. All Brahmanda. It's Jivamruta. It is Lord. One Swarupa will be one. Like Krishna also having different forms. Dwaraka is one type of form he's having. Vrindavan is one type of form he's having. Same person, but his Bhava is different. His Balaji is Jivamruta. Jivamruta means he'll give Amruta to the Jivas. That's why so many Jivas come here. Dhyanamruta, Jivamruta, Devamruta. Deities also different types of deities. One deity have one reciprocation. Some deities having a Devamruta. They give nectar to Devatas. Some deities, Dhyanamruta. You worship the Devata. You all went to, I think, Melkota. Melkota, you said. Melkota is Dhyanamruta. Here is Jivamruta. Lord Balaji will give Amruta to all the Jivas. That's why like honeybees they are coming here. All you can see, lakhs of people. You can see sometimes they are very, very aristocratic. Big, big people. But they stand 10 hours, 11 hours for Balaji darshan. Normally, this Indian Prime Minister or President of India, they have protocol. Protocol means only 15-20 kilometers they have to go by car, otherwise they have to go by helicopter only. But here, any Prime Minister, any Chief Minister, any President, they have to go by car only. They cannot go by helicopter, top of the Balaji. But still, they keep protocol side and go for by car only. Because on Lord Balaji, no helicopter can fly, no flight can fly. This is Supreme Lord. And him, Nobody can tell. They want to take darshan means, sometimes devotees they think, no, see, so many hours we stand. President of India also, he have to get down from the airport. By car, he should travel 2 hours. And there, 1.5 hour, that, you know, process is there. He have to be, President of India want to take darshan, any other places, only 1/2 hour, 1 hour. But Balaji darshan, he will take 10 hours for him. He's VIP. Like that, Balaji is, very, very special. Deva Amrata. For that also they are ready. 10 hours traveling, they are ready. Sometimes you see 3 days, 4 days, they are waiting in the queue. They are not upset actually. After darshan, so blissful there. 3 days waiting in queue line. After darshan, they are very blissful. They are very happy. And sometimes you can see there are rooms there. Big aristocrat people, they are sleeping on the roads in Balaji Hill. Thousands of people, you have not seen anything about that. Because their soul is satisfied. That's why it's called Jiva Amrita. Any person can come to Balaji, you will get nectar in the heart. And so told Amari Ahu Randa came here. He's a swam. And this is a hill is called, so many names is there, this hill. Today I will tell about Venkatadri, how Venkateswara, how Balaji name Venkateswara came, what is the, how this hill called, hill name got Venkatadri. Balaji name is?
Madhava Pastor.
Yeah, you told already? Oh, Madhava Pastor, I told. Okay, very good. I will tell about one more great devotee, Thonnamman Alvar. Thonnamman, he is a very great devotee, Thonnamman Alvar. Travel his previous birth, will become stunned. Thonnamman Alvar, it's a very beautiful pastime. Alvar's great Alvar's glorified Thonnamman Alvar. Alvar's also, even Ramadevacharya glorified Thonnamman. He's a very great king. Here, long time ago, very, very long time, one great devotee, his name is Vaikarasa. His name is Vaikarasa. Rishi, he's a Rishi. He's staying here, worshipping Balaji, Vaikarasa. And he's worshipping Lord very systematically. This wonderful worship. He's very, very, very powerful Brahmana. Very brilliant. He's very brilliant Brahmana, Vaikarasa. Near Ahobilam, one sutra has having Sudra person. Birth is a low birth. But he is also a very great devotee. One day, Balaji told to Vaikarasa, Rishi, one Sudra person will come to you, surrender to you. Please take his service. Take his service. We will do service for him. As for Balaji's prediction, one day that Sudra boy, all the way from this Avagala Kshetra, walking, came to Vaikarasa Rishi. Surrender to him. As per the instructions, he is serving him. His service is every day, early morning, he should go to the forest and bring the flowers. Balaji is Krishna. Balaji is
Krishna.
Balaji means Balakrishna. And he likes flowers. That's why always flowers, always in Trimala, he is all flowers. Balakrishna. He is more of Krishna. Always, he is boy. This Sudra by going and bringing flowers for the Rishi, that Vaikarasa Rishi, is offering to Balaji. That is serving. Very sincere, very sincere. He is a low birth also, but he is very sincerely serving. One day, he went to Alimani, he went for flowers. Then he saw in the Pushkar, you see in the Parak Pushkar, in the Pushkar, Gandharvas, they are playing, they are taking bath. Chitrada taking birth. And he saw Chitrada. He's named King, this Gandharva planet, King Chitrada. His name Chitrada. Mahabharata also comes with Arjuna, very beautiful pastime. Time is there, that also important instruction is there in the pastime. Chitrada is playing and they are now taking bath with his queens. The Sudrabai saw that. They are all taking, now Gandharva woman, they are very beautiful, very effulgent. His mind was bewildered. And he is going for flowers. and his mind got bewildered. And he's watching them. He forget his service. Sometime later, it will happen. We are in devotional service. Maya will catch. For Gandharva, one Gandharva only here. But you go outside, so many Gandharvas. They will catch you. Like, you know, we consciousness will be finished. We should be very careful. And as much as possible, pray to the Lord and come out from this illusion. And he is, you know, that nobody has to know my will, no one person. Any other person is there, I don't watch. That's why you should send us to be there. This person is watching, and his total body is contaminated, mind is contaminated. He got his enhanced powers is there, but body all got contaminated. Watching, you know, all human there, total mind, body, everything contaminated. Did not know this. My body, mind, everything contaminated, watching this Gandharvas. This flower should not offer, you know. It's offensive by me, contaminated person. He throw the flowers, take part again. Went for again for flower. He realized, oh, so big mistake I did. Now puja. Actually, this deity worship has a very systematic worship. Same time you have to offer. Now there is called Tomala Seva. Tomala means flower garlands. They have particular time. The time only they have to offer flowers to the Lord. That is the vidhi. That is the vidhi means there is a system. And flowers also, like before sunrise, or some time that they have, just sun is coming, that time sun is coming time, the flowers also they open. That time you offer to the Lord, the smell will come to the Lord. Flower seva is a very art, there is big art. Plucking is one time, offering one time, stitching one time. They have very systematic, beautiful arrangement for flower seva in Tirumala. And this Sudrabhai, so much now he is repenting. See, I denied the service of the Lord. So much time I wasted. Now again I should go for flowers and plucking the flowers. And he came running. Here Vaikana Sarusi is waiting. So much late, no flowers came, time on time. The Rushi asked him, why so much delay? Why you never brought on the time? For this boy, Sudrabhai, he never opened his mouth. Simply, he's shouting, Vaikana Sarusi is shouting, you delayed the Lord's service. And the boy is repenting. Lord Balaji told this to his boy. My dear boy, don't worry about your aparadha. This is aparadha, seva aparadha. And you do praya, I will take care of you. Praya means without taking food, living body. That is called praya. Without taking food, you fast and leave your body. I will take care of Balaji told. This boy, like that he did, follow the instruction, he never took away any food. This thing, without instruction, we cannot do. Balaji, very special mention, and he wanted it. And he fasted, that boy very seriously fasted, he left his body, that body. After leaving this body, that same boy, he born here only, this providence, as a king. His name is Tondaman Alor. He is acting 100 ways. Because his mind is in different mood. Balaji, Devu is bone falling. And he's become expert, he's become a Tondaman Alor. He's a king. With his family, with 100 wives, Tondaman Alor. King Tondaman. He became a king here. Same, this area only. His kingdom also very near from here, 70 kilometers. But he's having so many his family members, but his mind now on Srinivasa only. Because Balaji gave big kingdom to him, very big family to him. He's having big Aishwarya for Stonoman, and he's always attached to Balaji and serving Balaji. he's having one cave from his palace to Balaji, Tirumala Hill. He's having a cave. Every day what he'll do, he'll make a golden flowers, Tanuma. In that cave he travels, go to Balaji and offer to him and worship him, pray to him, sing for him, I'm coming back. And this is doing wonderful, beautiful service. Every day he's offering this golden flowers to Balaji. He's become very close, he's talking close to Balaji. That is, he's serving and he's now, after getting a king body, so much family, and he's detached actually, no more metal is there anymore. Lord purified him, totally to next. He gave him king body, big family, and he's totally purified. And he's totally concentrating on Lord's service. It's very pure service. One day what happened, he went to Balaji to offer golden flowers. Before he's going, he saw Balaji's lotus feet. One Tulsi leaf is there. That leaf made by mud. With mud, somebody made a mud Tulsi leaf and offered to Balaji lotus leaf. And this Tandaman prayed to Balaji, my dear Lord, I'm offering every day golden flowers. Now today I saw mud. With mud they made somebody and offered to you. Tulsi leaf. Who is that great personality? You are keeping in your lotus feet the mud. Nobody will keep, no? Mud, with the mud, who will keep? You are keeping so affectionately this Tulsi Patra made by mud. Who is that great devotee? And Balaji told, my dear Dandaman, this devotee is very, very dear to me. His name is Bhima. His name is Bhima. He stays in Kurva Grama. His village name is Kurva Grama. His name is Bhima, the devotee. He's path maker. His profession is path maker. Bhima's path maker. The devotee path maker Bhima every day in his house makes mud tulsi dala, mud with mud. And in house only he remembers me, offer to me. But I'll take that same Tulsi. With mud. No. Tulsi. Dala made by mud. Like a farm. Like a golden Tulsi leaf.
With mud.
Yeah, make as Tulsi. Farm. Like golden flower. Mud flower. Like that golden Tulsi leaf. Mud Tulsi leaf. And every day, this person, he don't have gold. This Bhima in Kurva Grama, he makes a mud. With mud, he make a Tulsi leaves, shape of a Tulsi leaf, and offer to Balaji. He is offering in the house, but Balaji will take in hill. The lotus feet, no? That leaves coming to his lotus feet. Balaji accepting. See? Whatever with love and affection you offer, wherever you offer, Lord will take. He's a powerful personality. You can, in the house you can offer, Lord will take care only. That is the power of the Lord. He's a supreme, he's Purna Purushottam. You can take offerings. He's somewhere in the village is offering that mud leaf with the devotion. Lord is taking here. That he told to his Tanuman. Tanuman has become very excited. My dear Lord, I want to see him. The great devotee, I want to see him. Vaishnava, he is Vaishnava. I want to associate with him. You go to Kurva Grama. You go and see him. Tanuman is a king. He may directly went to Kurva Grama. Then entering in the village, he asked where is Bhima's house. He told that is the place. He saw that this Bhima is making a pass, chanting the Govinda's name. Harinam is chanting Hare Krishna, Hare
Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare.
He is doing Nam Sankirtan. This devotee, normally they want to make mud pot, means they have to make mud first preparation with legs. Always he is making preparation, that time he is chanting. If any time, whatever work he is doing, he is burning the the pots that the apostle is chanting. He's making the pots is chanting. Always he's praying and chanting and remembering the Lord. Totally in Krishna consciousness. He's Dharmapatni, means his wife, and he is totally Krishna consciousness. Totally remembering the Lord. And the king entered there. He saw Thunderman Alvar. Oh, great king, you came here. He's did obeisances. And king also did obeisances to this Bhima. They both embraced. And Thunderman Alvar told to Bhima, my dear devotee, Bhima, Lord Balaji, very dear to you. You are offering mud leaves, but Lord is accepting you. Your devotion is so great. You are a great personality. I have to worship you. Lord told personally to me, meet you. Thunderman told to Bhima. And Bhima told, my dear king, Lord Balaji is speaking to you directly. You are a very great personality. His obeisances, his big obeisances. See, there are Vaishnava qualities like that. Normally, you know, bewilderment, what will happen? Sometimes we will think we are great devotees, sometimes. Anybody glorifies, you do wonderful service. You are wonderful devotees. Yes, we will think we are very wonderful devotees. There is the nature of a conditioned soul. But there are a conditioned soul. They are very exalted personalities. They're thinking we are not devotee. We're not devotee. He's Bhima thinking I'm not devotee. Thunderman is a devotee. Thunderman thinking he's directly talking to Lord. He's talking to Lord and his concerns are Sridevi Gurudev also they're talking. Both they're talking. To Thunderman, very close they're talking. But still he's thinking I'm not devotee. I want to see the devotee. Bhima. They both are embracing, glorifying each other. And that time, Pushyapa Vimana came, big, beautiful woman from Vaikuntha, and called Bhima and his wife. Your time is over, you have to go to Vaikuntha. And in front of Thunderman Alvar, this Bhima and his wife sat in the Pushyapa Vimana, they left to Vaikuntha. And this happened, this pastime happened. All of us are glorifying these pastimes, this beautiful pastime of Thunderman. Here, Thunderman and Alvar thinking such a great devotee is Lord given, so taken to Vaikuntha Loka Mukti. I am so unfortunate, Lord is given, not given to Mukti for me and is repenting. But Lord is very close to him. He is thinking like that, but Balaji told him, I will not send you, but wait, I will send you. Someone work is there with you. He is living, he is serving the Lord and serving the Vaishnavas. One day what happened? He is sitting in the kingdom. One Brahmana, his name is Vera Sharma. Brahmana name is Vera Sharma. He is also very, very brilliant Brahmana. Very exalted Brahmana, Vera Sharma. He came with his wife. His wife name is Lakshmi. Lakshmi is not only namesake, she is artist. Very beautiful qualities is having. He's a wonderful Pativrata. Pativrata means following husband. Very chaste. Very chaste, very pure. And this Brahmana also very pure hearted. They both want to go to pilgrimage. This Vera Sharma and Lakshmi. And what happened? They realized that this Lakshmi is a pregnancy. Pregnancy. That mother Lakshmi has a pregnancy. Vera Sharma is, you don't want to take her for pilgrimage because it's pregnancy on the way, something may happen. And they both Brahmana and Brahmana Patni, wife, they both came to Thunderman, Thunderman king. And Vera Sharma, the Thunderman also very exalted. Any Brahmana comes, he'll worship. He worshipped him. And Vera Sharma requested, my dear Thunderman, I want to go to pilgrimage. But mainly, I want to go to Kasi and take bath of Ganges. This is my life desire. Taking bath is my life desire. Previously, this yatra means their walk and go. Ganga bath is not another thing. Now, we have a lot of facilities you can go and take. Previously, 500 days back, 300 days back, you want to take Ganga bath means is lifetime goal. Lifetime achievement. They want to come to Tirupati means the lifetime achievement. Training. And now we have nice facilities. We can go for yatras very easily. 2 days, we can go to Ganga. Or one day, morning you go, take bath, and evening you come back. The facility we have. That is okay. But the time, this yatras is more intensive. very intensive. See, from here we want to go to, you are all coming from Calcutta, no? From here we want to go to, come to Calcutta means 5 days back. You can imagine how much time will take. We have to walk from here. Walking time we will meditate. When we will go to Ganga, Mayapur? When we will go to Mayapur? That thinking will be there, no? That will purify us. Intense thinking. On the way, we meet so many devotees. Totally depending on the Lord. Totally depending on that. We don't know. On the way, what will happen, we don't know. 100% dependency. 100% Krishna has so much intense. When will see the Ganges? When will see the Mayapur? That intense will be there. That is the major thing. In the heart, devotion will develop. Total devotion will develop. And in between, we'll meet so many sadhus, so affectionate sadhus. We'll share the tattva, discussion, association. This is a blissful life. Some months will take from here to walking to. Same thing from Mayapur to Tirupati coming, no? So many days, so many months they have to walk. On walking time, always chanting the holy name. Walking and chanting. No other work. Going for work. Meditation. Meditation. Now they are not meditate. They come with luxurious life, luxurious vehicles, and in between also they see TVs, cell phones. No meditation at all. In front of the Lord also, intensive meditation is not there. Yatra means you have to meditate in the heart, in the mind. You have to purify. That is the devotion. That's it. Rupa Goswami given known as Danga, devotion, visiting dhams. Our devotion should be tangible. That is the Yatra. That's the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu traveled. And Yamadharmaraja took as a Vidura and traveled. Great acharyas, they travel. They have so many yoga siddhis. They can fly. Our technology is nothing. Great acharyas, within seconds they can go to other places. But still they walk. Because they want to see the intensity. Walking time, months, weeks and months walking, no? To reach that holy place, thinking about that holy place, remembering and walking is the most beautiful thing. That is the main essence of the holy tirthas, visiting holy tirthas, mainly develop and affection for the Lord and love for the Lord. Then Veer Sharma, he is not going for his excursion there. For Punna is not going. He wants to experience his devotional service. This Veer Sharma with his good wife, he wants to go to Tirthyatras. Somehow, his wife pregnancy, he met Hanuman Alva and requested, "My dear king, I am giving my wife, please protect her. She is as good as your mother. Brahmana Patni is a mother. Atma Mata, Tada Prasni, Devur Dati Tada Prasni, Saptato Matra Smara, Brahmani Raja Patnika." It is all like Atma Mata means our own mother. Brahmani means Brahmana Patni, Raja Patni, Guru Patni, Devur Dati Tada Prasni. Devur means cow and Bhumata, nurse. These are all our mothers. Even Brahmana Patni, Raja Patni also mother. And this Veer Sharma requested Hanuman, "Is your mother? Please take her." Hanuman also gave one beautiful house and to take care of her. And he told to live in that house. And Veer Sharma went for holy bath. And he went to Kasi, took bath. And went from Kasi, he went to Badrinath. From Badrinath, he went to Muktinath. And all round, he went, and finally after 2 years, this Veer Sharma came to this place, Kanumanamma. He came, Shukla Paksha, Ekadasi day he came. Shukla Paksha, Ekadasi day, Veer Sharma came. And went to Kanumanamma. And he bought two pots of Ganges water. Ganges water is not available at that time, very, very precious. One for him, one for king, queen. He gave one bottle to King Tanduman and told, "My dear Lord Tanduman, my wife is safe, everything is fine with her." That time he remembered Tanduman Alva, when he handed over this Brahmana Patni and he told to stay in the house, he kept her in the house. After that, he forgotten. Tanuma Bhagavan forgotten. And when this Brahmana came and asked him, that time he remembered, oh, what happened to her? He ran. Instead, he saw, she is a very chaste lady. She not come out also. No food for her, no water, and she died. She died, and son also died inside. No body, only hasti is there. Hasti means what? Only bones is there in the house. Tanuma Nalwar became very sad. He's crying, beating his head. Such a offensive person. Forget him. What to do now? Crying, crying. And he's a devotee. And immediately, in the cave, he ran to the Tanuma. Normally, he's having a time. Some time only go. Practical time only go to Balaji. Untime is going. It's not time to visit Balaji. He's running. There, Sridevi Bhadevi saw him there. He's running and crying and coming. They asked him, what happened to you? Why you're crying, crying, crying? And he told, very big mistake happened. The crying and fell in Balaji's lotus feet and surrendered to him. My dear Lord, please protect me. I did a big offense. Very, very dangerous thing happened. Then Brahmana gave his wife to take her. I forget them. She died and only his bones, her bones is there. Please protect me. What to do now? What answer I can give to the Brahmana? And Balaji told, don't worry, I will take her. What you have to do? Tomorrow Dwadasi. My temple, Turpane. Eastern. Turpin. East. My temple east direction, Balaji told. One Kund is there. One Kund, beautiful Kund. Tomorrow morning, Dwadasi day, my dear king, Kanduman, you should take your all queens with chariots, with pallavis, at the same time with Brahmana, and this Brahmana's wife, skeleton also, put in the rat. And bring all together to Kund, that is called Hasti Tirtha, that is called Asti Sarovara. Then Asti Sarovara, you come with your queens and this Brahmana and the Brahmana's wife, bones also, that's Asti. You come and you and your queens all take bath and give bath to a Brahmana's skeleton also. Brahmana's wife skeleton also. Good thing happened to you, Balaji told. As per instruction of Balaji, this Tanuma went to his house. Morning Goddess Day, they all got up, including Tanuma and his wives and the Brahmana wife skeleton. They all carried by the palanquins and rats, they all came to Asti Sarovara. There, Tanuma took bath and his queens also took bath. Finally, they take skeleton of Brahmana's wife. They dip in the water. They dip and they take out. That Mataji again came as effulgence body. Brahmana woman became very effulgence. She came again life. Her body became life again. And her body, very, very effulgence. Her son also in the stomach, same son. And she got again life back, body back. Brahmana became stunned, Tanuman also became stunned. They are all worshipping the Lord and chanting holy name of the Govinda there. And the big miracle happened. That Hasti became a woman again. That skeleton became a Brahmana woman. Life got back. That is the devotion of Tanuma Nalwar. So devotion is having. And Balaji saved him. The Brahmana's wife again became a life came again. The Tirtha, that is called Hasti Tirtha. Whoever, anybody's bones you put in the Tirtha, they'll come back. But the Tirtha is not visible now. Tirtha is not visible. There is only Balaji can see. And this great devotee for purpose of Tanuman, Balaji showed the Tirtha. But still the Tirtha is there. That's called Asti Tirtha, Asti Sarovara. The Tirtha is existing. One more Tirtha is that is called Kaya Rasavan Tirtha. There is also direction is mentioned. The Tirtha specially is this Athisarovara is one thing, Kali Prasad Tirtha is one thing. That Tirtha is very special Tirtha that is comes after Papanasanam. I will tell about Papanasana pastime also. After Papanasanam, there is Kali Rasayana Tirtha. That Rasayana Tirtha is very special. You put any dry leaf in the Tirtha, that will become again green. Like a very tender green. Sanskrit explained, any human beings take bath in the Tirtha, their lifespan will be 10,000 years. Actually, Sanat Kumara covered with a big rock. You can see that rock also. Because simple people should not enter in that. See, we have now how much time? 60 years or 70 years? Our lifetime, what is the time now? What is the lifespan now? 67 years. 67 years only we cannot handle properly. 10,000 years, how we can handle? For 60 years, you do so many simple activities, some kalpa that fellow should be in the naraka. In the hellish planets, in 60 years span only, you do that much simple activities, that fellow should be in hellish planets from thousands of years and kalpas. So horrible, they cannot handle it properly. Why they are not given long life for us? Because 60 years only we are not handling properly. We are doing so many sinful activities. And in between, no? They cannot handle properly. There are so many suicides. Already we have alpha issue, very small life. In that term, we will be making suicides. Because of that, Kali Yuga people, long life is not necessary. Sometimes what happens, we do nice practices. Long life means again you will fall down. Short life means, short life very quickly we do. 10,000 years will give you luminous now, okay. No chanting, nothing. Oh, we have 10,000 years. We'll do last 100 years. No, we'll tell, you have only 60 years, 30 years sleeping, 10 years for you, only have 10 years, you will die very quickly. Okay, we'll chant. Kaliyuga, brains like that, but that's why no bigger life for them. Because they can't handle properly. Sometimes we think, why God is not given long life? Short life only, you are not serious. Long life is no serious at all. That's why these Atirthas, the purpose only they cover. They don't have any partiality. Lord doesn't have any partiality. Because we are not qualified to handle this Atirthas. We have very beautiful Tirthas in Tirumala. You take part in that, you get 10,000 years. You take part in this, you'll get fresh life again. You throw bones there, you'll get life again. That is called this Asti Sarovara, Asti Tirtha. That's special Tirtha. Very beautiful Tirthas in Tirumala. Imagine Tirthas. This is Vaikuntha. It's a spiritual place, totally spiritual place. Like that, so many Tirthas, Dhruva Tirtha, and Kumaradhara, and Sanaksanathan Tirtha, Tumbur Tirtha, Ramakrishna Tirtha, Nagar Tirtha, Chakra Tirtha. You have so many Tirthas. Each Tirtha has a big passion. Very amazing passion. When you know, is all you have. Papanasana. You know, you have to, I think, Darshan Guru. Next time you come for Papanasana Darshan. This Papanasana Tirtha is also very amazing pastime. It's there in Papanasana and Akashagaga. You know, Akashagaga. There's one scene. Akashagaga is a when Balaji marriage happened, that time, to give the ceremony part for Balaji inherited Ganga. Ganga flow from the Akasha, means sky. From the sky, Ganga flows and fall there. Akasha means sky. Actually, this is Ganga only. Ganga comes from sky. They enter in the Tirumalai, and that water they use it for Balaji's marriage ceremony. And personally, Mother Lakshmi gave ceremonial bath to Balaji, and she made a beautiful decoration for the Balaji, Lakshmi Devi herself. Like that, in Balaji marriage time, this Ganges came there through sky. That's why it's called Akashaganga. Till today, Balaji is drinking water from the Akash Ganga only, they bring to the temple. Every day night, two Brahmanas, by walking they go from temple to Akash Ganga. You have seen Akash Ganga is in the forest, almost 5-6 kilometers is there, from temple to Akash Ganga. Night time, they take torches and walk, they take golden pots, two police will be there with guns now also, and two Brahmanas. Their service is every day walking, going to Akash Ganga, take water, come back again. By vehicle, they not bring. Only by walk only, they bring. That water is only they use for Balaji's drinking, for Abhishek and other things they use. Here, there's a beautiful pastime in Akash Ganga. One Brahmana name is Punyashila. His name is Punyashila. Very, very wonderful Brahmana. Punyashila. He is serving as a Brahmana and he is learning all the Vedic Shastras. Wonderful, his Brahmana's duties he is doing. And he is all good qualities having, Brahmana qualities. One day what happened, his father's Shraddha Sharmani. Shraddha. This is called Samachari. Samachari. Every year, these Brahmanas they do their father's death ceremony, same tithi, but when his father left his body, the same day they do Samachari, means every year they do this Shraddha ceremony. Shraddha ceremony means they invite one Brahmana, make arrangements for nice prasadam, and offer to Vishnu, and worship his forefather, whoever his forefather, and giving them tarpanam. Tarpanam means giving devotional credits to his father through the devatas. And feeding a Brahmana. That day they call one Brahmana and feeding. Feeding means he'll get nice sukriti and his father also get benefited. His father also go to higher planets, mainly Vaikuntha. Then the Punyashila, his father's tithi, father death ceremony, after 1 year, Shraddha ceremony he want to do. And he called one Brahmana. This Punyashila called one Brahmana, made him sit and worshipped him. He served nice prasadam to him. That host Brahmana and took all the prasadam and blessed him, went away. It's all okay. But evening what happened is Punyashila face became a donkey face. Donkey face. His face became a donkey face. Any human being having a donkey face, you can imagine. Body, all human body, face is a donkey. And he is, you know, he is wonderful Brahmana. Suddenly after the Shraddha Sarvani, morning, afternoon Shraddha Sarvani happened, evening is where became a donkey face. No, sir. Anybody can stay like this in the house? Anybody keep him in the house? Nobody will keep him now. And he is very much upset. Same consciousness, Brahmana consciousness, face is Brahmana. And he is suffering. He cannot stay in the family. He cannot show his face to that face, all you can say, and you can serve. and his father started, what to do now? Who will save me? And I remember, I go to Dhimba, and came walking. He came to, that time Agastya Muni is here, Agastya Muni. You have visited that Agastya's ashram, I think, the temple, Srinivasa Muni. At that time, Agastya Muni is staying here, and he worshipping Balaji. Agastya Muni is very famous. You all know Agastya Muni. Somehow, this Punyashila went to Agastya Muni's ashram and they do business to him. And Agastya Muni also saw him. He is a very special person to take human form and Gardava face. Gardava. Nara Gardava. Nara Gardava means Nara. Nara Gardava. Nara Gardava. And face is a donkey face. And he is very upset and worshipful of Agastya Muni, my dear Rishi. And somehow suddenly my face turned to Gardava face, donkey face. I don't have any shelter. Please help me. Why this happened to me? Is he interested in Brahmana, no? Cause, what is the cause? Please tell me. What is the cause? What is the remedy? Please tell me. And Agastya Muni is a very expert. Mediated and told, my dear Brahmana, Punyashila, You are a very perfect Brahmana, but you did one big mistake. That mistake is, you did Saddha Sarmani. In Saddha Sarmani, you feel you are a Brahmana, but that Brahmana is not a qualified Brahmana. Unqualified Brahmana, you feel him. Because of that, you got Gardava face. Talking this, that Brahmana is unqualified. You don't have children also. You don't have son also, that Brahmana. You feel him. Actually, devotion service is very special. You go to Karma Kanda, these actions will come. Devotion service, you can feel anybody, prasadam. You, thank you, man, get back in this. But you go to Karma Kanda, you do these things, you have to call only qualified people. Then just see. Actually, it is the same process, very wonderful process. We feel Brahmana only, but in unqualified Brahmana. The Brahmana and no son. There is the unqualification. Who have taken food, the Brahmana and no has son. In Karma Kanda, any who has son, Brahmana, he don't have son means he is unqualified. In Sisamalaya, they are not to sannyas also. Anybody who doesn't have son and daughter, they are not to sannyas also. This Karma Kanda is like that. Devotion service is very special. Whatever Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is given to us is very special. Very wonderful. This what is the sloka? Prabhupada quotes. Devarshimunam, Pitranam, Nakinkaranamaya, Municharajan, Sarvatmananam, Saranam, Saranam, Katro Mukunda, Kalipti Kratya. No obligations. Whoever surrender to Mukunda, Krishna, no obligations. Deva Shranam, Pitranam, Deva Shranam, Pitranam, Nakinkaranaya, Municharajan, Sarvatmananam, Saranam, Saranam. Once you surrender to Mukunda, all obligations gone. That is the power of devotional service. You go to Karma Kanda, you will get religious body, religious letters in this. You see in the Tanth Kanda of Bhagavad, Nruga Muhara's got religious body. They look very strict, very austere, so much, but still they stack up. It is Brahmana, very pure Brahmana, but Karma Kanda portion is like that. You should not go for that. For seeing, no, this Karma Kanda portion will be very nice, very wonderful, but it is not useful. It is not useful. And Avesta Muni told, you did wonderful sarmani, but unqualified people. You feed him in Saddha Sarmani. Because of that, you got Gandhava face. And he asked this Munisila, my dear Avesta, please tell me, what is the remedy? Don't worry. No, you are very near. You are near. Now, Supreme Lord is here. He is Dinabandhu. Not his, Dinabandhu. Whoever fallen, he is a Bandhu. He is a relation for him. His relation. For whom? For fallen persons. He is a relation. Relative. He is a relative. Lord is a relative. For whom? Whoever fallen, he is relative for them. Normally, anybody fallen means relatives, they throw out. Real relatives, they throw out. But he is a very wonderful personality, Supreme Lord. He is a Dena Bandhu. Dena means fallen persons. He is a relative for fallen persons. You go to him, then he is having a beautiful titta that is called Akashaganga. You go and take bath, all things will be perfect for you. And he did ocean this Punasela. He walked the hill and went to the directly. Gardava face, they are not allowed inside the temple also. First things. Directly go means he learned. They are not allowed Brahmanas, they are not allowed to take darshan. Directly went to the Akashaganga. There he went and he took bath there. When he took bath, immediately, in that second only, this Gardava face is gone. His offense is all sinful actions gone. His face again, his beautiful face came out and he's very, very relaxed now. Very happy. That is the effect of this Akashaganga. Whoever takes their bath, all offenses, knowingly, unknowingly, whatever you do, that all offenses will be. That is the dashing of Akashaganga. And this Ananda Chaya was talking to suppose. You have heard about Anandacharya's last time with Balaji. some other pastors also, Anandacharya having. One day, Anandacharya from his house coming to Balaji temple to take Balaji's service. Very chill. Tirumala climate is very chill sometimes, very cold. He said, backside of the temple, one leopard, animal, tiger, leopard, cat family. This leopard, old leopard, and he's almost very old, very sick, no food, and skeleton, like, you know, bones only. No food for him, and he's fallen there, and ready to die. No food, old. That is another chair, the leopard, and he's become compassionate and went to Balaji, and he gave flowers for him and worshipped him. And he's very grave. Balaji asked him, "What happened to you? Why you're grave?" He told my dear father, "I want one boon." He never asked for any boon actually. "Whatever you want, tell me, I'll give." He asked him. Anandacharya asked, "My dear, I want one boon. What is the boon means?" "Whoever takes birth and dies in this hill, they should go to Vaikuntha. They should not take again birth here, material world. That is boon I want." Actually, Anandacharya is not seeing external feature of this leper. He is seeing Janma Mrityu. So what is death? This living in is going on the cycle of birth and death. Normally, nowadays people, they see old age means they'll take and then put in old age home. Old age home they put it. But this very, very intelligent person, Anandacharya, he knows the truth. He's seeing living entities is suffering. Even in suffering from Janmamrityu Jaravali. Not only this leopard body. It will die. Again it will take birth. Again old age. Again suffering. So much suffering for this living entity. I have to do something. That's why he prayed to Balaji. Any living entity, any creature take birth and dies in this Tirumala hill, they should go to Vaikuntha. Means no birth, death, old age is for them. He asked Balaji, granted for him. Okay, take it. And this is going on. One day, Anandacharya, he want to go to pilgrimage. He is packed in prasad. All wonderful prasad with dry leaves, and then with the disciples is going to come down from hill and going to the pilgrimage. They walk some distance and they want to take prasad. They opened all the packets. In the packets they saw all ants in there. Ants know. Sometimes keep prasad, ants will come. They smell they come. In the packets, lot of ants is there. And another chakshar is all packets and ants. He told, "Please don't take prasad and close all prasad. Pack again." They packed everything and told another chakshar, "We go to again back to Tirumala." From the place where they stopped, again they walk back. They walk back and went to Tirumala hill. And then nobody knows why he's going back. And he told, "Put this all. This prasada and ants mainly in the ants is there, no? Put them on the hill only again." And they ask, why? Yes. "See, I have a boon. Whatever living in the ball and dies in this Tirumala hill, they go to Vaikuntha. Now we take in prasada. In that prasada, ants also came. That ants belongs to Tirumala hill. We are taking ants from Tirumala hill to far away place. Their replacement will be denied. That's why we again keeping back the ants and putting in Tirumala hill. They'll go to back to Godhead." And he told to his disciples, and they all wonder how compassionate he is. Actually, he's having a boon, whoever living and take birth. Ants also know. They should be in Tirumala only. Again they put all ants there and again walk back again to Tirumala. That is the nature of a wonderful Vaishnava. Anandacharya. One day, Anandacharya is picking flowers in Tirumala. Actually, these flowers I told, no? The flower seva is a very auspicious seva, service. Pushpa seva, that's a pushpa kankarya. normally previously what they do, we are devotees, they select the flowers. Mainly, flowers should be nice fragrance, nice color, for body also, to wear Balaji or Lord Krishna, that feeling, Lord should get feeling, very smooth feeling. Nowadays flowers should take things like, you know, but in needles, put here, then you know, needles, not like that. They should be very smooth for body also, for Lord should feel smooth, color should be very bright, and smell should be there. Let the trees, plant the trees and grow them, and early morning they pluck the flowers and they make a garland and give to the Lord. That is there. Very beautiful. The Lord also accept them. They become happy. Another acharya, he is doing the devotion service. He is growing the this trees, flower trees. You know, Prabhu also told you know how they are digging the well and Mataji helping him. His own well also he died for water to pour the trees. And like that is very much, very beautiful garden is developed. Anandacharya developed. And Balaji want to make him fun, Anandacharya. And morning, that all this grow up, beautiful flower came. Now, next week, next day, every day you have to pick the flowers, send to the Balaji. And all flowers are ready now. The harvesting time came. Night, what happened? He's sleeping. Anandacharya is sleeping. Balaji came to the garden with Lakshmi. Coming there, one day came. And Lakshmi also told, we want to visit Anandacharya garden. We want to see. Balaji also said, these are having. We want to go to Anandacharya garden to see. They came up from the temple. And Lakshmi Devi and Balaji sitting in the garden. Balaji taking one flower from the tree, plucking, putting to Lakshmi Devi here and seeing this is not good, throwing again. Again, one more flower, taking and putting to Lakshmi and seeing, no, this is not good, throwing. Then all the flowers stitching, removing, putting on Lakshmi, again throwing. Then the total flowers they destroyed and walked here and there, some trees also collapsed and went back again. Morning, Subrata and then they both went to temple. Morning, Anandacharya came, he saw total flowers destroyed. And he is very angry. What happened? Some thief coming and destroying my garden. I have to do something. Look, tonight also, this thief will come, I will catch him. Second day night, Anandacharya sitting under the tree watching which thief will come, hiding. Same thing happened. Balaji and Lakshmi, they plan today also. We will go today also. Balaji told to Lakshmi. Lakshmi said, we will go today also, we will see. And Lakshmi Balaji came. Same thing now happening there. Some flowers is leftover flowers are such there. Balaji picking that one and blessing to Lakshmi. Again throwing. Anandacharya become very wild. Last Maya, no? That very last energy, Yoga Maya. He is very angry. He wants to catch both and take. And he ran to catch. Balaji escaped. Lakshmi got caught. He tied to the tree, big tree, he tied Lakshmi Devi. And he took his stick and sitting, your husband should come and believe you. And he tied Lakshmi Devi there and sitting there. And morning, these Brahmanas, they opened that door for Suprabhatam. They saw Lakshmi Devi is not there in his chest. Lakshmi Devi is missing. And Balaji only is there. Without Lakshmi, they cannot worship actually. Without their offering system is there. How they can do Suprabhatam? For Lord, without Lakshmi is in the heart, chest, Lakshmi Devi is there. No Lakshmi Devi there. And Brahmanas, they asked him, Lord, where is Lakshmi? Where is Lakshmi? Then Anandacharya, no bound her. Taken, rope with rope is bounded by him, and they all went there. He went there, and Anandacharya with stick is sitting there. Brahmanas went there, my name Ananda, give Lakshmi Devi. Tell that Srinivasa should come here. I'll give his husband only to come and relieve her. And they told, otherwise you are not worship. No. You should go and tell, you should come here and take his wife. Otherwise I'll have you. And they went back, they told, my dear Lord, Anantacharya is not living. And he's keeping his stick there and sitting there. She's also not escaping, can't escape. And, okay. What condition? Is having any condition to release her? Then ask him. Only one condition is calling you. No, you should ask again. Any condition is there? Any other solution is there? Ask him. Again, Brahma went to ask him, my dear. Anantacharya, any other process is there to release her? He told, okay, one condition. Today onwards, Lakshmi, you should accept as my daughter. Today onwards, she is my daughter. And Srinivasa as my son-in-law. Like that, they accept means I'll carry her with my basket and leave to him. And Balaji agreed for that. And they made big basket and sit Lakshmi in that basket. Anantacharya carried as his daughter and went to hand over to Balaji. He's a son-in-law. Like that, he made arrangements and hand over to Balaji. And that day onwards, Lakshmi became his daughter actually. Every year, Balaji comes to his house, now also. Every year he comes to Anantacharya house as a son-in-law and accepts all the bhoga offerings. Two times he comes, Brahma also time, when he bathed, no? With this Kropa, that day was, that same day, three day comes, and this day, when basket, no? He carried. And he is having a relation as a father for Lakshmi. Let it pass him. Like that, great devotees, there in Dharmala, yes sir. And recently also a pastor happened, recent pastor is. Prabhupada asked me, like pastor. We call that pastor, like pastor. This is connected to Sarada Sarmaya only. This is not in scriptures. One Brahmana told me, one of the main priests of Dharmala, he told me that there all the Brahmanas, they respect Iskandiya very much. They have so much honor, they have so much respect of Prabhupada and Harinam. They love Prabhupada and the organization. They share their religiousness. One main priest, when they came to Jambola and speaking to us, and he is only doing Balaji Tilak, he won't do Tilak, he'll do Abhishek for Balaji, he'll offer food to the Balaji, that considered service is doing to Balaji. And the Brahmana told about his grandfather's, forefather's experience in past life. His grandfather serving in Balaji's temple. That time, no TTD organization also. The Mahant means they have one type of administration. They are doing administration, Mahant. One day, one Brahmana, morning, early morning, one traditional Brahmana, went to the Sanctum Sanctorium, early morning, puja, morning, Balgoka time. And they chant, first, before starting puja, they take Sankalpa Mantra. Sankalpa Mantra means they chant all the Sankalpa. Sankalpa, the Sankalpa for Sarvejana Sukhila Bhavantu. They take Sankalpa. I am worshipping the Lord for which purpose? To get all living entities. Shema. Shema means auspiciousness. To give all auspiciousness to all the living entities. That is the Sankalpa. For that purpose only, they do worship for the Lord. They ask, Lord, after worship, you bless them, all living entities. Sarvejana Sukhino Bhavantu. Means all living entities should be happy. And they should be very auspicious for them. For that purpose, they do the puja and abhishekam. And the Brahmana chanting is Sankalpa. Mantras. Sankalpa mantras means they chant, you know, which year, which month, which date, the tithi, all will come. The tithi, in chanting time, he remembers that day his father's tithi. Today is his father's Shraddha ceremony, father's death ceremony. He remembers, oh, I came to here, I have to do Shraddha ceremony to my father. That is the day, tithi day. And already he came for Balaji worship, he cannot go back again in between. And he is thinking, oh, I cannot go back now because I started worship of Supreme Lord. At the same time, I cannot, without doing my father's sangha, his big offense, he's thinking and worshipping. Suddenly when I came to him, he did all worship for the Lord and he offered all the offerings. And finally, he wanted to do Shraddha ceremony there only in Saint Sandori. He did, because no, he cannot go back. In Saint Sandori, in front of Balaji, he did all the Shraddha ceremony pujas. In Shraddha ceremony, he had to invite one Brahmana. No Brahmana. He called Lord Balaji as a Brahmana. And he made Ashan, and he made Agya, and Padya all, and invited as a Brahmana guest, as a Brahmana only. Made Asana and put all the offerings there, he filled him with mantras. He did all Shraddha ceremony, there only inviting Balaji as a Brahmana guest, and he completed his all Shraddha ceremony. After Shraddha ceremony, one more Nema is there. What is that Nema means? After eating that guest Brahmana, this Grihastha, he should eat in that same plate. In Sanctum Sanctorum, nobody can eat, but in Shraddha ceremony, Nema, he should eat. After eating Brahmana, he should eat. And that same plate, whatever happened to Balaji, that plate is eaten inside of Sanctum Sanctorum, that Brahmana ate. Everything is okay. That Brahmana completed his work. And very silently, went to his home. Completed worship and Shraddha ceremony, everything. He offered Shraddha Bhoga to Balaji. And that same way, he ate. Everything went in. He went inside, a very happy mood, he went there, completed work. Evening, other set of Brahmanas came. They are doing evening worship. Some Brahmanas doing worship, some Brahmanas went to the kitchen. That time, no gas. Now also, not much gas they used. For that, often they used firewood only. With firewood, they are cooking them for the Lord. This some Brahmanas, they are cooking Brahmanas, evening for offering the Balaji, they are trying to light the firewood. But firewood is not burning. So much their hard work they are doing, only smoke is coming, wood is not burning. No fire is coming in the kitchen. They are doing so much, they put carbon everything, but firewood is not taking fire. And all they have seen, so much tea they put to light the carpura they put, but still no fire is coming. They thought something wrong is happened. Because of that, kitchen fire is not coming. They understand. And now they all discussion is going on, all Brahmanas they gather on this very big issue. Without firewood not coming, means they cannot cook. Without cook, no cooking item, without boga, they cannot do worship to the Lord. And they all Brahmanas gather and discussion is going on. Finally they concluded, we do Anjana. Anjana means there is a process. They ask Lord only with Anjana, what mistake we did? Why in kitchen fire is not coming out? They will ask Lord only. There is a system, Anjana. They make an Anjana. In Anjana, Lord revealed to his main priest. See, my dear Brahmanas, purposely I am not allowing you to light the kitchen. Yes, the reason is there. Morning, that Brahmana feed me Shraddha Bhojana. Shraddha food. In the Vedas, one custom is there. One Nema is there. What is the Nema? One custom. Whoever Brahmana, he takes Shraddha Bhojana afternoon, evening, you should fast. I took Shraddha Bhojana, evening, I should fast. See, the Brahmana boiling very good, like strict regulations of Shraddha. Balaji also boiling. Whoever takes that food to afternoon, Shraddha Bhojana, you should fast evening. Now you cook means, you offer to me, I have to eat. That's why, no cooking. I am not allowing to cook. And the Brahmana becomes stunned. Such a big thing happened. And he requested the main priest, my dear Lord, you supreme Lord, you should not fast. You should be fast means very, is that a big thing? It's a big thing. Anishta is offense. At least you take, don't take this grains. You take dosa. the logo yellow, and the yellow, and they did the fire, and they made the dosas, they offered to Balaji. Till today, even dosas they offered to Balaji. The same dosa is continuing today also. Normally, breakfast and dosa they eat now, Balaji will eat evening also. In this recent fashion, this happened, very nice fashion. Balaji very nicely pacificus. One more question of Balaji. One day Anandacharya is doing service. He is very sincere because service, always serving mode, Balaji serving mode. Early morning he went to his garden to pluck the flowers. And he's speaking from suddenly one cobra came and bit him. Cobra. Hit him. And his disciples, they are seeing cobra coming, snake, and beating him. Anandacharya saw that and he did not care for that. Again picking the flowers. And the disciples questioned, "My dear Guru, please take some medicine. Cobra is very poisonous. And you may die. Please take medicine." Because no time is there, no, the time only you should give flowers, you should pack the flowers. On time you have to give the for Lord worship. You should not miss. You go for medicine means no, service will go away. I will not go. After completion of my work, I will pick the flowers. My personally every day service is taking flowers, putting in the basket, taking to Balaji temple, giving to the priest and coming back. After this giving the garlands, flowers to Balaji, after that only I take the message. Otherwise my service time will be affected. He told me. And all these disciples went and informed to Pujaris. And Pujari informed to Balaji. Anandacharya, very arrogant. Adamant is not coming take medicine. He is already bitten by snake. And Balaji called on Pujari and told, "Tell Anandacharya, I am calling him. I will tell him. Calling him, you should give medicine to him." And Brahmana went and told, "God is calling you." And he told, "No, I'm not coming." He Brahman went and told to Balaji, "He is not coming." Balaji became very upset. "Okay, so come on and see." And finally he took flowers on with basket, normal time only. He's coming with flowers, went inside the temple. Balaji told to the pujaris, "Close the curtain." They all closed curtain. Back side there. Balaji, curtain this side, another side this side. And he's bringing flowers. Balaji told, "Stop. You stop. Don't come." Another side, "Stop." Balaji told, "See, I call means 33 crores of devatas will come. Not will come. Brahma, Shiva, Indra, from Kali, therefore all will come. Not only this parent, all parents, Brahmas will come. You go to one person, Jiva. Why you not coming? This is what again you are. You did Deva Aparana. You did offense to me. You should not live here. Go away." Another Charya, he told, "My dear Lord, whatever is here, there is truth. But you should understand, you should hear from me also. See, here, whatever, Balaji told you, don't give flowers also. Don't give flowers, you don't stay here also. No service for you, no staying facility also. You go away." That is the Balaji's declaration. No seva, no staying. Another said, "Told, my dear Lord, see, you are not calling to hear. My Guru Maharaj, Ramanujacharya told me to go here. I am not serving you. My Guru Maharaj told me to serve. His service is flower service. He told me to make a flower garland. You be you. I am not serving you. I am serving my Guru Maharaj. You don't want to take my Guru Maharaj service, that is okay for you." And he told, that is the legal point. No, he is not serving him, Balaji directly. His Guru is given his service. Guru's service is doing. Ramanujacharya service, Anantacharya is doing. This is my Guru Maharaj service. You don't want Dhammajanacharya service? Okay, I'll go away. No. You will lost. Second point is, here this Kshetra is Varaha Kshetra. And when you came from Vaikuntha, you requested Varahadeva some place to stay. And he giving rent for him. And you are also tenant. I am also came here, I am also staying in rent house. You are also tenant, I am also tenant. One tenant have no rights to send another tenant. You don't have any right. You are also tenant, I am also. You are also staying in tenant house. You are paying interest with tenant to Balaji. And I am also staying here. Later he argued. Balaji defeated actually. Finally he told, no, you are very great devotee. Because I don't want to lose you. You die means I cannot tolerate. Because I call you. I know your power. You're so affectionate for me. My service is so dedicated to Guru and me. I don't want to leave you. I don't want to go or die. Again he spoke, another side. My dear Lord, you tell him this I'm dying. I'm not taking a sentence, I will die. You're thinking that poison will affect me. Okay. Anyway, the snake is very poisonous, means whatever snake is bitten me, so powerful that poison means I will die. No problem. I will leave my grass body. Go to there, take bath in Virja River and go to Vaikuntha, taking bath in Virja River. I will serve you same service there. Where? In Vaikuntha. Flower service. Otherwise, I have another snake inside. There is snake having five woods. Five woods. There is called Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Madha, Matsarya. Five strong inside. Ahankara. And all. That snake, inside snake is more stronger means outside snake, poison will not affect me. Inside snake, poison is more powerful means outside snake, poison will not affect me. I will not die. I will go to your Pushkarni, Varaha Pushkarni, take bath and serve you flower service. I am Vaikuntha and in Goloka. My activity is only one activity. What is that activity? Serving you. Balaji has become very angry and embraced me. Anantacharya. That is the Anantacharya. That much is having on his Guru. Guru is given service to him. He is very sincerely serving. Whatever difficulty is coming, snake is within him, but still he is continuing his service. Because of the surrounding nature of Guru, Balaji is reciprocating him very wonderfully. He is having a wonderful relation with the correct. Any questions for him? Yes.
So I heard the Prabhupada also told that Balaji is Balakrishna. Then he took darshan. Then in Venkatesh, I was hearing there was no post class. In Venkateshwara Mahatma also this told.
Yes.
But we heard this past time that now Vishnu is coming as Srinivasa. With respect to that past time, Bhrigu Muni.
Yeah.
So how Balaji is Balakrishna? This I'm not understand. And Srinivas is also performing the main pastime of marriage with Padmavati. So how Balakrishna?
Prabhupada mentioned, actually Balaji is all Bhava, total Bhava is in Krishna Bhava only. What Lord Krishna having is Bhava mood, in that mood only. And same thing, Yashoda Mata came as a Mokala. And you can see in Venkatachala Mahatma and Padma Purana, Lord Krishna giving moon to Yashoda Mata and coming as a Srinivasa. Again, as a Srinivasa. Our understanding is, sometimes Krishna also shows forehand form, sometimes in Devaki, Devaki's. And he shows Krishna only, sometimes he shows forehand form. But Krishna only. When he took birth, First he showed to Devaki Mata in the jail, forehand form. In Rasa dance also one time, and Krishna showed this gopis, forehand form. Like that, Krishna sometimes will take forehand form also. The bhava will be Krishna. Like that we can take this. Balaji, his forehand form is there, but still is Krishna. Because Yashoda Mata is there, Bakalama is there. And he says in Puranas, when his wedding is happening, he says he's Vasudeva, my son of Vasudeva, my mother is Devaki, my brother is Balaram, my sister is Subhadra. He is mentioned in marriage ceremony, the same thing is mentioned to Akash Prasad. It's Krishna. Sometimes not Krishna, for pastime purpose, he takes full and form. Understand? Sometimes he will take full and form. Krishna will take sometimes full and form. So many places in Brahma Vimohan Leela, he took full and form. And Rasa dance in between Rasa dance, full and form. But for the purpose of this pastime, he took full and form. Normally, when he is with Vakulamayi, marriage is certain time, he don't have four hands actually. When Srinivasa married Padmavati, only two hands, no four hands. Yeah, two hands only. And Ramanujana keeps Senko Chakra. Even Srinivasa Chetra, Ranganadeva don't have four hands. He's also only two hands. He's also two hands. Srinivasa, two hands. But worshipping is Chaturbhuja. Bhava is Chaturbhuja. Ramanujana kept two hands. Only two hands not having this. Like this. Ramanujan kept that one. I don't want to go to controversy.
I read in Desire to that. Ramanujan kept the disc and punch and the neck.
That's this, yeah. Because of no same ways. Because, see, when Vakulamayi with Srinivasa, it's two hand form. Total pastime, Balaji pastime, Lord never showed any Chaturbhuja Rupa. Now, presently we are worshipping Ajit Chaturbhuja Rupa Vishnu. But originally Srinivasa only two hand form. Okay? In that connection we should accept him as a Balakrishna, Balaji. Because Yashoda Mata is there. Morning offering also, you take matan. Morning first does no Brahmana will go there. Kavarta will go there. Morning, Suprabhata time, first entering Sankar Chandolim, Brahmana will not enter. Kavarta will enter and say. Today also, I saw that. Every day. Yadavas, they come in Yadavas. Any other note? Yes. Yeah? Mahaprabhu visited. Yeah, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu visited Tirumala. He mentioned Chaitanya Chaitanya. And he took Venkata, he visited Venkata Chala. He took Darshan of Venkatadri, Balaji. And they visited here down Rama, Sri Rama temple. Tirupati down Sri Rama temple is there. He visited here. And Nithyananda Prabhu also visited here. That is mentioned in Chaitanya Chaitanya. Particularly, pastimes we have not mentioned. What pastime happened is not mentioned. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu visited here.
Yes. This, I heard in 2012 also you gave us class in the farm, PDC or Nikuramachari devotees. That time also you told that this Balaji pastime happened in the last Kali Yuga.
Yeah.
So the question comes that this Vedavati pastime happened not in this Treta Yuga.
Yeah.
So, then this pastime of Mother Yashoda getting the desire of seeing Krishna's marriage.
Not in this
Dwapara Yuga. So, did this Krishna pastime means Mother Yashoda and Krishna pastime happened in the last Kalpa, or and I've heard little bit that many times in this Dwapara Yuga Krishna came personally, but in other Dwapara Yugas Vishnu came as Krishna. So what is the fact? It's what do you know?
See, anyway, this Bhagavad lot pastimes is Kalpa Bhera. This is called Kalpa Bhera. Each Kalpa having different aspects. 100% sure Balaji Diti is not this Kali Yuga. Because this Kali Yuga means Balarama also said this. This Balarama, the operator is dead.